Hi, I'm Lekha. Welcome to the series of news podcasts by Susian Classes. Today, we'll be picking up two areas of relevance for UPSC.
Started. Our first article we will be discussing is that of National Green Tribunal on cigarette butts, and the second one will be on Rafael jets. Let's quickly go through this article. This article is important for your environment part of UPSC. And it reads, frame rules for disposal of cigarette butts. It is a statement made by the National Green Tribunal. Let's quickly go through. The following report filed by the Central Pollution Control Board, the National Green Tribunal has directed the board to lay down guidelines pertaining to disposal of cigarette and BD butts within 3 months. This 3 months is important because they have given them a deadline. Then the report, based on the study conducted by Indian Institute of Toxicology Research, they have said that this waste is within prescribed limits, so it's not very toxic. But another important thing here that has happened is that the National Green Tribunal had said they will not reject the export report on the basis that tobacco is anyway harmful for everybody. So now let us see what all we'll discuss in this particular article. We will see the effects of cigarette butts on the environment. We will read about cellulose acetate, which is a part of the cigarette filter. We will see what is the role of NGT and what is CPCB. These two are mostly important for your prelims perspective. Now let's see, in reference to the article, let's see what are the points. The doctors and NGOs have come together to build pressure on the central government so that it declares cigarette and BD butts as toxic waste. A particular NGO called Doctors for You has filed a petition with NGT. The NGT has asked the Union Ministry for Forests and Health and Family Welfare and the CPCB to file their responses on the harm caused by cigarette or BD butts and chewing tobacco. Based on this report itself, which was submitted by CPCB, the NGT has made a decision that within 3 months there has to be guidelines on the same. This is all because WHO released an report in 2019 on the global tobacco epidemic. And after this, the CPCB posted an expert committee report titled on the effects of cigarettes and BD butts. All of this is because there are 100 million cigarette butts which are non-biodegradable, which are thrown every year in India itself. Another interesting fact is that the Howrah Bridge, whose pillars are reportedly corroding due to the acid in tobacco residue. And we all know that the saliva in tobacco users is laden with carcinogens and toxic chemicals which contaminates the environment. This is a statement made by the doctor who had filed the petition on behalf of Doctors for You. While India is working towards Swachh Bharat, 100 million billion non-biodegradable cigarette butts are getting disposed of into the environment every year. There are no known processes for segregating or collecting cigarette butts in the world. This last statement is very important because if there is no process, it's going to be very difficult for us to segregate and process this waste. Talked about in this article by this little snippet.
This routine, iconic. And let's forget the health issues, that's obvious. We're going to focus on this part right here.
As you can see, this is mainly about the disposal of tobacco and BD butts and not about smoking. So for our UPSC point of view, these points are very important. This is about the Central Pollution Control Board. Let's see what it is. It's a statutory organization. That means it's established by law. It was entrusted with the powers and functions of the Air Prevention and Control of Pollution Act. By the way, this was formed under the Water Prevention and Control of Pollution Act. The main gist of what they do is they promote cleanliness of streams and wells and they improve the quality of air. They also undertake functions under the Environment Protection Act of 1986. They are constantly provide technical services to the Ministry of Environment and Forests. So in a gist, they undertake water, air and environment concerns. They're a statutory body, which is the advisory body as well as a regulatory one. Now, we'll see what the National Green Tribunal does and what they stand for. The NGT was established under the National Green Tribunal Act of 2010. It is a special tribunal, that is, it is set up for expediting the process of issues of environment which come to it. And it has to dispose of all applications within 6 months. This is very important because this is the main reason why it was constituted, to expedite and ensure that there's an effective process of expediting these applications. New Delhi is the principal place of sitting, but there are four other places they sit: Pune, Kolkata, Chennai and Bhopal. And any person who's appointed to the National Green Tribunal has a 5-year term and there's no reappointment. This especially goes for the chairperson, who's elected by the central government in consultation with the Chief Justice of India. And there are other members who are the judicial members and the expert members in the tribunal. There are at least 10 and maximum 20 of these full-time members who are elected by a selection committee formed by the central government. Now, what is the effect of cigarette butts on the environment? First, let us see what is in a cigarette. It contains stearic acid, toluene, nicotine, ammonia, methanol, carbon monoxide, arsenic, methane, acetic acid, butane, cadmium. All of these are very harmful substances, not only to our body but also the environment. They're even poisonous to our lungs as well as the environment. We will see how. Cigarette butts, when left in the soil, can harm all plant growth. Nearly 10% of the grass growth or germination has been cut down by 27% due to throwing of cigarette butts on the ground. A cigarette butt can cut down the germination or development of plants, as we've just seen. And it is ingested by wild animals, which produces a lot of problems since they get stuck in their throats or even sometimes causes poisoning to them. And they may suffer or die. It blocks drain pipes and enters into waterways, causing water pollution. Now, this we have seen. It's the same as plastic pollution. Cigarette butts is also considered as a part of plastic pollution because they have the same effects. And there is the most important point, which is it's a fire hazard. Around 1,100 fires have occurred due to cigarette butts in the last year in Hyderabad itself. And there are a lot of cases of forest fires, although it is mostly a natural phenomena. It has also occurred due to throwing of cigarette butts. Discuss what is cellulose acetate and what are its effects. The core of most cigarette filters, the part that looks like white cotton, is actually a form of plastic called cellulose acetate. This is why we think that disposal of cigarette and BD butts is a part of plastic pollution. The reason it is so is because it's very slow to degrade in the environment. It can take up to 18 months to 10 years for a cigarette filter to decompose. And cigarette filters are full of toxins, but the used ones are even more filled with toxins. And sometimes the filters are discarded with bits of nicotine or tobacco, which pollutes the environment further, also associating with nicotine pollution. So basically, this is because cigarette filters are designed to absorb some of the toxins in smoke and collect solid particles known as tar. An interesting fact to know is that cellulose acetate fibers in a cigarette filter are thinner than a sewing thread, and a single filter contains more than 12,000 of these fibers. And the white paper that is attached to a filter actually consists of calcium nitrate, so that it doesn't stick to the smoker's lips, and this further degrades the environment. Now let us see the highlights of what we've learned. 100 billion cigarette butts are disposed in India yearly. Cellulose acetate is the main problem of filters, and hence being the problem of these filter disposals. These cause plastic pollution, and NGT is a specialized body which has a term of 5 years. I mean the members, which are the expert members, legal members, as well as the chairman. Go to our second article, which deals with Rafael. It reads, Rafael is a game changer, says Rajnath, our defense minister. This is him with his French counterpart Florence Parly. The important points of this article are: Defense Minister Rajnath Singh on Thursday called the induction of the French Rafale fighter jets into the Indian Air Force a game changer. Next, the IAF plays an important role in maintaining military deterrence, and their actions will be decisive in any future war. With the prevailing situation on our boundaries have caught our attention, we should not ignore the threat of cross-border terrorism. This is with reference to the recent incursions of China at the line of actual control. The five Rafales were inducted into the number 17 Golden Arrow Squadron. This is the first imported fighter to be inducted since the Sukhoi 30s came from Russia in the late 90s. What will we discuss in this article? In reference to the article, we'll see some important points. Then we'll see the features of Rafale and what this induction means for India. With reference to the article, some important points here are: formally, the IAF has inducted the much talked about fourth generation French flying machine called Rafale. The first batch of five aircrafts is formally inducted on Wednesday. Mr. Rajnath Singh, who was present at the event, said the IAF plays an important role in maintaining military deterrence, and actions will be decisive in future while prevailing situation on our borders have caught our attention. This is again with reference to China. French Defense Minister Florence Parly said that in strategic terms, India would have an edge over the entire region with the induction of Rafale. In a joint statement of both Rajnath Singh and the French counterpart, they have said that this is a step forward in the strategic partnership of India and France that dates back to 1998. Let us see some features of Rafale. It is a multi-role fighter. You can see some statistics here: the max thrust, limit load factors, max speed. This max speed basically translates to 2000 kilometers per hour, and it is a powered French Snecma M88 turbofan jet engine. The French word Rafale means gust of wind. It weighs around 9500 kgs. It can lift around 9500 kgs worth weapons also. It doesn't require a runway of more than 400 meters, as you can see here, landing ground in 450 meters, and it just requires a runway of 400 meters. Basically, it has a Spectra system, which is important, which has been developed by Dassault. It is a fully automatic electronic security system, which costs of 30% of the entire cost of building the Rafale. So these are some important points. Just please remember that it's a multi-role fighter. Although it is not a stealth fighter, it also performs the functions of a stealth fighter. And now we'll see some facts on Rafale. With its outstanding load carrying capability, its advanced mission system, the Rafale can carry out both air to ground strikes as well as air to air strikes, and it can also perform interceptions during the same time. The Indian Air Force decided to test out the competitors of Rafale 2 before taking it in. So they released a tender. After some time, Russia had offered MiG-35 and Sweden had offered JAS-39. USA offered their F-16 Viper and F-18 Super Hornet. But the Indian Air Force had decided on Rafale in the end. Now, some other features are: it's capable of performing several actions at the same time. We had just discussed that it's a multi-role fighter, that is air-to-air missiles and low altitude penetration phase. It's an omni-role capability, which is a very interesting feature of the Rafale. Now, the most interesting feature is this one. India has an offset partner with Dassault, which is Reliance Defense. And after the first consignment has reached India, the rest will be made in India in the Make in India initiative by the Modi government. There are also some criticisms with respect to this. It is one of the most expensive aircraft in the international market. It is worth 60,000 crores for 36 jets. Experts argue that its high cost is a result of many reasons, including the general inefficiency in the country's defense. The maximum speed of this is around 1.8 Mach, which is compared to the Chinese J-16s,
is at 2.2 mark. So Russian avian experts have claimed that the Rafale jet would be useless against the Chinese Air Force, the People's Liberation Army Air Force. So this is a problem, and the Rafale's practical ceiling is also lower than the J-16s. Even in engine thrust, the J-16s or also the Russian Sukhoi 35s are far superior to the French combat aircraft. Even if the Indian Air Force were to deploy all 36 of its newly acquired jets, the technical superiority would still be on the side of Russia. So this is a problem which we are faced with. Now let us see Rafale in action. This has been posted by the Indian Air Force.
Let's go to the highlights of everything we've discussed about the Rafale jets. The first of the five Rafale inducted. It gives a strategic edge to India. It's very expensive, may prove problematic to India. Rafale is an updated version of Mirage 2000, not a great fighter against Chinese J-16. So earlier the Mirage 2000 was inducted for the Kargil war and it helped us win. So because of this, actually, the Indian defense wanted Mirage 2000, but the French had stopped producing it, and Rafale is just an updated version of it, which is why we have inducted it into our arsenal. Now let's move to the D&D segment of our video. The UPSC General Studies mains daily practice questions. You can find questions every day on the official website of SOSIN Classes. Let's discuss today's questions. First one is from the general essay paper. How is temporal distribution of rain going to be problematic in India, and what are the requirement government's resolve to be taken up? The second question is that from GS2. Explain in brief growing opposition in Tripura's large-scale Bru enclaves resettlement. The third question is from GS paper 3. What is the need for farming guidelines for the disposable of cigarette butts? Then the short question from GS paper 2 is, how will India and Japan's logistic agreement lead to closer cooperation? Now, let us see the prelims practice question. To overcome the dilemma over deficit monetization, which of the following steps are to be brooded by the RBI? The options are the possibility of monetizing the debt, higher borrowing in the current year, ease liquidity through open market operations. You have to choose the options, either if it's 1, 2, 2, 3, 1, 3 or all of the above. Please get back with your answers to us, and you can check tomorrow's paper for today's answer. From yesterday, what's the UK's internal market bill called? The answer is C, legal safety net. You can find other answers and other questions on our website. Please do check it out.
This is a wrap on Your News Podcast. Tomorrow is another day with another news. Please like, share and subscribe.